My name is Jamin Goecker. I'm a realtor in South Central Alaska, and my mission is to help you to build an intentional and significant legacy for yourself and your family by coaching you in real estate. And the purpose of today's video is to discuss some of the dark sides of what it's like living in Anchorage and just living in Alaska in general. So keep in mind, these are going to be my opinions, and I'm going to do my best to make sure I don't step on any toes here. So before we do get started with today's video, do make sure you give this video a like and make sure you subscribe so more people can see content like this in the future. And without further ado, let's go and jump into the top kind of dark side items of what it's like living up here in Alaska. Now, the first thing that I'm going to be really talking about is just the seasonality up here. And this gets talked about a lot, but it really is true that it's something you have to kind of consider if you're moving up here. Some people do really well with the change in seasons and it's just fine. Other people really are on the struggle bus during the winter months. And when I say struggle bus, I mean really struggling mentally with a lot of mental health issues, trying to get through kind of the dark winters, because it is a big impact. If you've not been in the dark for a significant amount of time, you might not 100% kind of know what I'm talking about, but it is something you just need to experience, kind of get it. So that's number one. If I'm talking about the dark side of living up here, literally, it can be dark for a significant amount of time. Now, not as much as if you lived up in Fairbanks or Barrow or somewhere like that. If you're in South Central or Southeastern Alaska, it's not nearly gonna be as extreme, but certainly you're still gonna get that, get kind of that challenge of it being dark for a significant portion of the year. And, you know, light and bright during the summer months. So that's just something you need to expect. Now, the second big thing you need to consider that kind of falls more into the dark side column of living up here is there is a high crime rate in Alaska just as a whole. So I haven't really talked about this a whole lot in the past, but it's something I do need to kind of address here. So the crime rate is going to be high. That being said, though, keep in mind crime rate and overall number of crimes is not going to be the same thing. Alaska's a pretty small state. There's only just over 700,000 people who live here, so somebody acting a fool and doing something they shouldn't up here is essentially statistically going to be doing the same amount of work that somebody that would take 10 or 20 people in the lower 48 to do to make the statistics swing in either direction. So that's number one. It's not Mayberry, but also there's a whole lot less overall crime being committed here than there are in other places. For instance, I'm not going to name the city in Texas, but one city alone in 2019 had over 101,000 crimes being committed in that one city alone. Alaska as an entire state had under 28,000 crimes being committed. So yes, the rate is going to be high, and if that's all you're looking at, then it's going to be pretty scary. It's going to be full-on Gotham up here. But if you're looking at overall number of crimes, not really going to make that huge of a difference. What I always tell people, what you're going to be comfortable with as far as crime is going to be something you're going to have to determine. So go to whatever police department, crime map website that you have of the place that you're looking to move into and really check it out and make sure that you're comfortable with the level of crime going on in that area and just to make sure the crime kind of fits whatever flavor you're into. Number three is that it's certainly a little challenging to get places just because it's so isolated up here. So for that reason, you can feel kind of boxed in and a little isolated, and this really starts to compound during the winter months when it's really dark. So this is another reason why it's so important to plan some kind of out-of-state trip to some kind of a sunny location during the winter time. The next thing is, though it's not as expensive as the cost as other states and other cities and the cost of living index across the US, it's still pretty expensive to live in Anchorage specifically. I saw somewhere I think it's about 28 or 34% above the average cost of living just across the entire country. That being said though, you can definitely find a lot of cities in the lower 48 that are a lot higher than that. So just something to keep in mind though, it is gonna be more expensive here. Food, transporting stuff, it's a longer supply line. So just something you need to be aware of. Let's take a quick break here. So I do have an Instagram page in addition to running the Alaska Realtor YouTube channel. Link for that is going to be in the description down below. So definitely go check that out. It's going to be kind of showing what it's like living on the last frontier up here in Alaska, selling real estate, you know, interacting with a lot of folks, a lot of which, you know, I've met right here on YouTube. And it's going to be a great place to just see what the Alaska scenery and the hiking scene is like up here, because I do that quite a bit. So go check that out and slide into my DM. I'm usually pretty good on answering any questions that you have there. So let's go and jump back into today's video. The next thing that doesn't get a whole lot of attention is Alaska really doesn't have a whole lot of roads. Now, this is a problem if you're trying to do some kind of a road trip or trying to get somewhere. It's something you kind of have to take into consideration. A lot of towns here in Alaska aren't necessarily connected to the road system. As a matter of fact, we can't even get to our capital by road. So it's a purely a plane or boat kind of a deal trying to get in there. So not a whole lot of roads, and it's a little concerning when like Anchorage is going to be connected to the rest of the state, at least going north, by a couple of bridges, and those bridges go out, then that's going to be a problem. So the next point that I'm going to jump into is earthquakes. You know, that's obviously going to be a side of living up here in Alaska you just kind of have to get used to. I don't think anyone likes earthquakes. I sure as though heck don't like earthquakes. Now with having, you know, a property in an area that put a significant amount of time and energy into, I really don't want to see anything happen to it. So that's going to be part of the show up here. Luckily, buildings are built in such a way that they really do sustain a lot of earthquake movement without having any kind of actual damage. You might get some cosmetic cracks here and there, but by and large, you're going to have way less damage up here from earthquakes than you would like from tornadoes or hurricanes or, you know, pick your natural disaster. So that's good. We've adapted. You know, the next one here doesn't get a whole lot of attention, and this is one you're only going to get after living here for a while. But for me, it's a very transitory state. You're going to meet a lot of people, and they're going to be cycling in and out, either with the oil field or the military, or people just moving up here for a little bit to get it off their bucket list. That's all fine and good. But if you're kind of a permanent party up here, it does make it a little challenging to kind of build relationships with people, because usually you're going to have 3 to 5 year talks with somebody and then they're gone. So that's, you know, that just is what it is. And, you know, it can be a little challenging building relationships with people when, you know, you've always got this this timeline you're probably going to be working on. And last but not least, mosquitoes. Again, I've said this in multiple videos, I really haven't had a whole lot of bad experiences with mosquitoes up here. I lived in Texas for a while, so I'm used to like a ton of bugs and scorpions and, you know, beetles, all this crazy stuff year round. And you get mosquitoes for maybe a couple weeks out of the year up here. I don't know, maybe I'm just not going to the right places, or everyone complaining about it's not going to the right places. I don't know. For avoiding mosquitoes. You guys just need to hang around me. I know where to go. So those are going to be kind of the dark sides of living in Anchorage and living in Alaska in general. I sure hope it was useful. If you do have questions, do make sure you reach out to me through my Facebook page. The link for that is going to be in the description section down below. Alaska is an absolutely beautiful place to live. It's a place you should definitely consider if you're looking at making a move and making a change. But they're definitely is a dark side of living up here, just as there's a dark side with living anywhere. Unless you're living in cotton candy land, it's just not very realistic that you're gonna be able to find perfection. So do reach out if you have questions. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.